On December 6, Senator Ron Wyden alerted the Justice Department to a startling issue: potential surveillance through our everyday smartphone notification. He specifically questioned the role of Apple and Google in discovered monitoring. Allegedly, these companies have been handing over push notification data to government agencies, both foreign and domestic. And today we dive into this explosive story, examining the implication for our digital privacy and freedoms. What does it mean for you, the user? And join me to uncover the layers of this critical issue. And to fully grasp the concept, it's essential to delve into the process of how push notifications are managed on smartphones. So when you install an application and grant it permission to send push notifications, the app generates a unique device token, specific to both the application and your device. This device token is sent to the application server, enabling the server to send targeted notification to your device. When a new notification is to be sent, like a message or update, the application server creates the notification content. The notification is then sent to Apple's push notification service, APNs, for Apple devices, or Google Cloud Messaging for Android devices. This is where Senator Wyden's discovery becomes crucial. According to the standard process, the transmission of the notification to APNs or Google's cloud messaging is usually encrypted to protect the content. However, Senator Wyden's findings suggest that before this notification reaches the respective server, APNs or Google's cloud messaging, they might not be encrypted by default. This implies that there could be a window where the notification content is susceptible to interception or surveillance. Now, APNs or Google service delivers the notification to your device guided by the device token. While the content might be encrypted during transmission, metadata like the identity of the application, the time the notification was sent, and the device it was sent to could still be accessible. This metadata can reveal patterns in user behavior and application usage. The key takeaway here is that while the notification content is generally expected to be encrypted during its transmission to APNs or Google, there might be stages in the process where encryption is not applied by default. This gap could potentially be a privacy concern, as it might allow unauthorized access to the content of the notification before they reach the encrypted channels of APNs or Google service. To take it a step forward, imagine every buzz and beep from your smartphone is a puzzle piece in a vast digital landscape. This isn't just about who texted you or which application sent an alert. It's about the hidden metadata that comes with each notification. This metadata contains timestamps pinpointing the exact moment you received the message, application identities revealing whether you are a news junkie or social media addict or a fitness enthusiast, and sometimes even location data sketching a map of your daily travels. For federal agencies, this metadata is a treasure trove. They use it to weave together patterns of your life. When you wake up, which application you use to connect with the world, and where you spend your time. This isn't just data. It's a narrative of your digital life pieced together through a seemingly incautious notification. The feds can track potential suspects, understand behavioral patterns, or even prevent crimes by connecting these digital dots. Reuters said that according to their information, governments have been able to use this metadata to help tie anonymous users of messaging applications to specific Apple or Google accounts. Now let's take an example scenario, protesting activist, as an example, okay? So let's start with the situation. Imagine an activist who uses a secure anonymous messaging application to coordinate protests in a country with a strict government. The anonymity measures, the activist, aware of potential surveillance, uses an alias on the application and communications only through this anonymous profile, believing their identity is protected. Now, metadata collection. So each time the activist receives a message or update through the app, a push notification is sent to their smartphone. These notifications carry metadata like timestamps when messages are received, frequency, how often the activist communicates, and possibly the device unique identifier. The government, through surveillance programs, collects metadata from various sources, including tech giants like Apple or Google. And by analyzing this metadata, the government notices a pattern. Specific device, identified through its unique identifier, regularly receives notification from the anonymous messaging application. So the government cross-references this data with other databases, such as mobile network operator records, to find out which Apple or Google account is associated with that specific device. By doing that, eventually the activist's real identity is uncovered because their personal Apple or Google account is linked to the device receiving this notification. And now, the government knows the true identity of the anonymous activist, comparing their safety and the anonymity they relied upon. Scary, huh? So Apple has already responded to the letter of Senator Ron Wyden by promising to add requests for push notification to its regular transparency reports, starting with the next one issued. According to TechCrunch, Apple has also updated its law enforcement guidelines, and now Apple requires a valid judge order before handing over records of users' push notification to law enforcement. Google has not made any specific commitments, but issued a response saying that it shares the senator's commitment to keeping users informed about this request, and that its existing transparency report have included requests for push notification records as part of the aggregated published number. Now, James McQuiggan, security awareness advocate at KnowBefore, notes that push notification can also be used for more direct acting attempts. He says that cyber criminals continue to use phishing attacks with the added features of utilizing push notifications. The cyber criminals have increased the attack vector and scale. It's been uncovered they are using push notification to millions of Apple and Google phone users, making it one of the most significant phishing attacks we have seen in recent years. Now, some consideration to protect against this type of attacks are to be cautious of push notification, only download application from trusted sources, and keep mobile devices and computers up to date to reduce the risk of a more significant breach. Avoid push notification that ask you to click on links or download attachments. Now, if a notification appears to come from a bank or retailer that is not recognizable, there is a likelihood it's a phishing attempt. Only download application from trusted sources such as the application store or Google Play, as this will reduce the risk that the application could be malicious. Keep your operating systems and application up to date and patch any known vulnerability that cyber criminal hackers could exploit. It's always better to be safe than sorry, so have a healthy skepticism when receiving push notification on smartphone or internet browser, advised McQuiggan. Now, as we navigate this evolving story, it's important to remember that many details are still unknown. We are at the juncture where awareness is key, but concrete conclusions are yet to be drawn. My commitment is to keep you informed with accurate and updated information as the situation develops. This issue is a reminder of the ever-changing landscape of digital privacy and the complexities involved in balancing securities and individual rights. I encourage you to stay tuned as we continue to delve deeper into this matter and unreveal the implications of these recent findings. If you like such content, please let me know. Leave your feedback in the description. If you like the video, please press the like button. If you are not yet a subscriber, please do. And until the next video, see you.